Hello, good day. It's your guy, Coach Happy Marcel. Today I want to speak with you about the shock of fear. The shock of fear. So many people on earth are proud of their wealth. Some are proud of their financial status. Some are proud because they have some spiritual power. And some are proud because they have influence. So a lot of people are proud of so many things in life. Recently, I've been in the hospital, and often I do visit hospital, but there is an experience that I got, especially this period that a lot of hospitals are busy because of a pandemic caused by COVID-19. So I noticed that so many people right there are dying in the hospital, not because of this so-called coronavirus. So many people are dying in the hospital because of fear. Yes. At the reception of the news that they are positive, some immediately will develop high blood pressure, some will just collapse. The virus actually is not the one killing them. And now, including Christians, they also panic and also experience the same thing as unbelievers. And I started being marveled at their faith. And I'm asking myself questions upon questions, what is the basis of their faith? On what does their faith lies? You know, there are some people in the hospital today. The reason why they are panicking is because they were so proud of their money that money can solve so many things on earth that even money they believed could give them good health. But when they received the news that their president, their prime ministers, their ministers and top people that has money more than them are dying of COVID-19, so that fear will shock them that if people that have money more than me are dying of this illness, who am I? There are some that are worthy, there are some that are influential, and they rely on this their power, and they think that no matter what happens on earth, that their status, whether financial or influential or the political power they have, will help them. But they are seeing it wrong, and reverse is the case. Opposite of what they have ever thought is now the case, because they can see that neither money nor influence nor anything else could save them. Even the medical expert, their prescriptions are failing them. So they are now beginning to look for solution outside what they have thought to be the solution that would help them in life. And today, so many of them are now asking the question, how can God save us? What are we going to do to be saved by God? Now, this is synonymous with your foundation. I am marveled about the faith of so many people. What is your foundation? If your foundation of your strength is based on money, if the foundation of your strength is based on your wealth, if the foundation of your potentials, what you called your stronghold, if the foundation is based on your influence and not in God, not in Christ Jesus, definitely you will be disappointed. And this is exactly what they are facing. Yeah, they are being disappointed by their wealth, even by their doctor. They said, I have doctor. Anytime I am ill, even before I could get ill, my doctor will come and check on me. And even your doctor is afraid and your doctor is terrified about this present situation. So, what am I saying in essence? This is a call to revisit our foundation. Where are we from? We men came from somewhere, and we know that our manufacturer is God. We have abandoned God for so long, and you know, there is an adage that people normally said in my country, Nigeria, that when the breeze blew, they will know the trees that are strong. And this is the time. Your foundation matters a lot. If your foundation is not based in Christ Jesus, even the news of this coronavirus could harm you. When you hear, or when your doctor will tell you that, oh, you tested positive, that news alone could kill you. Why? Because your foundation is not based on Jesus Christ. You already know that money is not helping out. You already know that everything you have, every foundation that you have apart from Jesus is not helping out. So, that thought alone could lead you to so many bad things. That is why I'm still reaffirming that there is one Lord and one Savior, that is Jesus Christ. The world for long have deviated. We have deviated a lot. It is time for us to come back to Him. It is time for us to come back to tell Him that we are sorry. There is nothing He cannot do. I am a living testimony. Jesus is still healing. Jesus is still serving. Jesus is still doing a lot of things as He did in the days of old. And the most important thing you have to understand about coming to Jesus is that there is no barrier that can hold you if you believe that you want to come back to Jesus. There is no barrier out there, and you don't need to do much. It's all about believing and submission and carrying out His will. What is your foundation? The shock, fear. You can never be shocked, no matter the news that comes to you. Why? Because you have Jesus Christ, who is above everything, and you know He can do all things, no matter what. Here's what I have for you today.